morning. Today I'm sharing my story of the process we used to move our Jamf Pro instance from on-premises to the cloud. My name is Kimberly Trojanowski, and I work at the School District of Waukesha in Waukesha, Wisconsin. I'll begin by explaining why we moved to the cloud, followed by what we did to prepare for the move, what occurred on moving day, and finally, what needed to be done after our cloud instance was up and running. When we first started using Jamf Pro, known as Casper Suite at the time, we had 10 iPads that were purchased for use by our special ed department. We set up one Windows server that ran our Casper instance and MySQL. We gradually purchased more devices, and eventually the district chose to use Apple devices for our one-to-one program. By the time we finished deploying all the devices, we went from 10 iPads to over 14,000 devices and 1,400 computers. Our server setup went from one server running everything to three servers running Jamf Pro, one primary and two web app servers behind a load balancer, a separate server running MySQL, and eventually two MCache servers. Now we are in the cloud. And this is how we got there. We began the process by scheduling a call with the professional services engineer assigned to assist us during the move. During the call, we discussed our current environment. I sent him a Jamf summary of our environment. I asked any questions I had about the process, and we set a cutover date. Finally, after the call, I notified staff members of the scheduled cutover date. During the call, the engineer recommended that we clean up any unneeded items in our database. I went through and looked at our policies, groups, safe searches, apps, ebooks, and deleted any of these that were obsolete for whatever reason. I then cleaned up the items in Jamf Admin and our file share distribution point. I deleted any obsolete packages, doc items, printers, and scripts from Jamf Admin. After the cleanup of Jamf Admin, I then deleted the unneeded packages and ebooks for a file share distribution point. If the file share distribution point is located on an in-house Windows server and a package is deleted from Jamf Admin, it doesn't remove the file from the distribution point. I could have skipped this step since eventually the distribution point wouldn't be needed, but I'd like to be thorough. A couple weeks later, it was moving day. That morning, I sent an email to staff reminding them of the outage. Then that afternoon, at our scheduled move time, I connected to the WebEx meeting our engineer had set up. Once connected, I flushed our log files in Jamf Pro and sent a Jamf summary to our engineer. He reviewed the summary to make sure that there weren't any significant changes in our database from the original summary I sent him. Basically, he wanted to make sure that the size of the database hadn't grown unexpectedly. I then disabled Tomcat on our three web app nodes and sent the service to disable instead of automatically start up, just in case one of our servers was accidentally restarted by another member of my team. Our network admin then added the CNAME records for our new instance given to us by our engineer. Then it was time to back up the database and upload it to a Jamf Dropbox. Our engineer received the database backup and sent it to the cloud team, and we waited for them to do their magic. After the engineer received notification from the cloud team that our new cloud instance was ready, we completed the final steps of the move. I logged into Apple School Manager, created a new MDM server, downloaded the token for the server, and then uploaded it to Jamf for automated device enrollment. I then edited our pre-stage enrollments to look at the new automated device enrollment instance. We tested enrolling a few devices, installing printers, and verified scripts still worked. And then since we have a connection to GSX to look at purchasing information, I needed to upload a new GSX token. The last step that day was to shut down the servers that weren't needed anymore. This included the MCache servers, the database server, and the primary node. That left us with two file share distribution servers still running. A few weeks after the move, when I was sure that everything was stable in our environment, I replicated our packages to the new cloud distribution point. I made it the primary distribution point. Then I modified each package policy to point to the cloud distribution point and deleted the file share distribution point from Jamf. Since these were Windows servers, as a security measure, I also disabled the AD account that was created for the shared folder. Once that was done, I shut down our backup file distribution share. Besides serving as a file distribution point, our remaining server contained our in-house ebooks. Before the server could be shut down, I moved each ebook to the database. To do this, I had to delete each ebook entry in Jamf and then re-add them. Changing location within the entry wasn't an option. Once this was done, I was able to shut down our final server. Our Jamf Pro instance is completely in the cloud now, and with a little planning, the move from on-premises to the cloud was much easier than I expected. I hope you enjoyed my presentation, and thank you for listening.